riot. Police and residents at the Dale Farm Traveller site in Essex are continuing into their fourth hour. Police have used tasers on two protesters and one person has been arrested.
The operation to clear the site began at 7 o'clock this morning. Officers in riot gear entered after breaking down a fence. Since then, they've been moving through the site, removing barricades. The travellers and their supporters are resisting all attempts to carry out the evictions. Keith Doyle has the latest.
All legal routes had run out for the travellers facing eviction from Dale Farm, and shortly after 7 o'clock this morning, time ran out also. Lines of police in riot gear moved onto the site, entering it from the back. Residents claim negotiations between them and officials taking place at the front gate were a distraction. Some fled. This woman ran from the police carrying a baby in her arms. As the large numbers of police moved through the site, they faced strong resistance from protesters. Bricks and missiles were thrown at them. The police responded. Here, they can be seen using a taser gun.
It's outrageous, absolutely outrageous what this country can do. You think you see this in a third world country. This is Great Britain, Great Britain. It's just disgusting how they treat this, how they treat the travelling community. Absolutely appalling.
To have me decided to caravan there by the truth, because I just wanted to get out.
A last-ditch legal move by Dale Farm residents was rejected yesterday by the Court of Appeal, which gave Basildon Council the go-ahead to evict them today.
We've done all we can over the last 10 years, and certainly since September the 19th, we've been trying to find a negotiated, peaceful solution to this. Unfortunately, it has proved to be fruitless, and particularly with the so-called supporters, protesters, who have no doubt added to the complications and have caused a lot of the scenes that we've seen today.
A large number of police vehicles have been in place nearby since the early hours of this morning, as well as ambulances and medical teams. Throughout the morning, the police have been trying to clear the site. The residents who've remained, along with the protesters who joined them, have been doing all they can to halt their progress, chaining themselves to railings, climbing scaffolding and erecting barricades. The police say they have made some arrests and there have been some casualties. The police operation is to clear the site of protesters to allow bailiffs to evict those residents who are there illegally. Gradually, they have been evicting people. Some put up a protest.
This eviction is unjust.
Others resigned to the situation. Keith Doyle, BBC News.
Well, we'll be live at Dale Farm in a moment or two. Before that, let's just have a look at a map showing the geography of this site. Looking south across Dale Farm, the illegal half of the site is on the left-hand side of the screen.
Then at the bottom there, you see the main entrance. That is where we've seen that standoff between bailiffs and travellers and their supporters really going on for about a month now.
Then, as we've been reporting this morning, at 7 a.m, police crossed a field and stormed the site by breaking through fences erected by the travellers and activists. And there's now this standoff with activists who've attached themselves to 40 feet of scaffolding erected beside the main entrance. Well, let's speak to Mary McCarthy now, who's a Dale Farm resident, and she joins us on the line from the site. Good morning to you. What have you made of events through the course of this morning?
I'm speaking now, yes?
You are. What have you made of what has happened there at Dale Farm this morning?
My friend, Nora Egan, has after been airlifted to hospital because the police came in at 7 o'clock this morning and pushed her against the wall and a fence and it crushed her back. She was airlifted. She cannot feel her legs at the moment in the hospital and we're very concerned about her. They also got a Margaret McCarthy shoved her so hard, when she hit the wall, she has no face. All the side of her face is all scrope and taken for life because he also was on a machine for breathing. They turned the electric off and they don't know if he's going to make it or not. It's like a war zone in here, it is. And I hope that Tony Cameron is proud of himself for insisting that this eviction went on when he could have done something else. They're trying to put us into houses. They're trying to ruin our community, and they're not going to do it. This is not about Greenbelt land. This is about getting rid of the gypsy and the traveller community of England, putting them into houses. We are entitled to live in our caravans. Leave it be settling or leave it be where we want.
You clearly... Sorry to interrupt you. You clearly are very unhappy with the police's tactics, but we're seeing the pictures of protesters. They have been chaining themselves to various bits of scaffolding. They've been resisting any attempts to move them. Bricks have been thrown. Were police not put into an impossible position here?
This is not a bailiff's eviction. It's the police's eviction. They were actually here to say that it was going to be a good eviction and it wasn't a violent eviction. They're starting with the... They're up there living as a right off the beating everyone with their bats at 7 o'clock this morning, for God's sake. These people here are trying to defend themselves, throwing stones at them the best way they can. They're putting spray into the people's faces. They're falling on the ground like flies.
Just a final question, because this eviction is clearly proceeding through the course of the day after all of these years. Where do you think you will end up at the end of today?
Wherever we will end up, we'll have to prove a point. They will not get rid of gypsies and they will not get rid of travellers.
But do you know where you're going to go to?
We're going outside. When the gate is in and they've come out, we're going to live outside the gate because the gate is a private road and that's where we're going to live. Or else we have all tents, and we're just going to put up our tents here, there and everywhere and just sleep in them. Where else will we go, for God's sake? What's wrong with the government of this country? I can't... You'd expect to see this in a different country, and if it was, England would be the first to intervene, spending their money flying food in and flying medical teams in to help them, and they won't have their own country.
OK.
And it's making me sick.
Mary McCarthy, thanks for talking to us. Thank you.
Well, we are staying with this story, of course, as you would expect. Let's cross to our correspondent, Mike Sargent, who is outside the perimeter, Mike, I believe, still of Dale Farm. Now, you may have heard one of the residents there saying to us that what the police were doing was outrageous because they were effectively going in and acting as bailiffs. I mean, just to clarify, I guess the police would say to you they are going in to clear things in order that bailiffs can then do what the law says they must do.
Yes, that's right. So it's a bit of a change from what Basildon Council had said initially, which when we were all gathered here 4 weeks ago, when we thought the evictions were going to begin then, the council said the bailiffs will go in and they will only be supported by police if they are needed to keep the situation safe for the protesters, for the travellers and any other observers. But we heard in that interview with Tony Ball, the leader of Basildon Council earlier, that the plan changed a bit, particularly overnight, and he said that was because they had evidence from inside the camp that there was more of a potential threat, and that is why in the end it was a police-led operation. So the police went in at 7 o'clock this morning and they did that, they say, to secure the site, and now the bailiffs have kind of followed in behind them, so it's a bit of a reverse of the original plan. Now the bailiffs are moving through the site behind me. They have come from the other side, from the back entrance where they breached that fence earlier on, and they've been trying to dismantle the main gate from the other side, and some of them are doing it from this side now as well, moving in with sledgehammers and so on. Still, I think they're proceeding quite cautiously at this end of the site at any rate, because protesters are still 40 feet up on that scaffold, and they have to be very careful how they get them down and try to do that as safely as possible in this very difficult circumstance.
Yes, and presumably, Mike, the authorities would say this situation today continues. We continue until the job is done, even though it seems that some people, and we'll talk more about this in a minute, but some people are arguing that there could be yet another legal challenge to this.
Well, yes, I mean, there was that last-minute injunction a month ago when the bailiffs appeared to be going in and then they had to stop and call a halt to the whole thing as the various legal challenges went through the High Court and then most recently in the Court of Appeal on Monday. So, the travellers have always, at every point, their representatives have tried to challenge the legality of Basildon Council's actions. Now, initially, it was an argument about the planning law and about the human rights of the protesters, but most recently in the courts, it's been about the actual eviction plan itself, the clearance, whether the council was overreaching its legal agreed basis on which it would be able to clear the site, whether it was acting disproportionately. That was rejected by the Court of Appeal on Monday again, so we'll wait to see whether there's any further challenge, but certainly observers are here. The travellers have their own observers and the protesters as well, and they are watching everything that happens. They're watching what the bailiffs do, what the police do, making extensive notes, and if they feel that the council's gone further than it is able to, they will no doubt make that clear to us and others.
Indeed. All right, Mike, we'll be back to you as soon as you have further updates. Thanks for now. Mike Sargent, just outside the perimeter there of Dale Farm.
Well, let's speak now to Grattan Buxton, who's the secretary of the Dale Farm Association. He's on the line from inside the site, and thanks for being with us. Our correspondent just saying that the council saying that the tactics had changed, it became police-led, because the threat level had changed. Do you accept that?
That's right. I have been 50 years in the travellers' civil rights movement since the 1960s and the foundation of the Gypsy Council. We have never seen anything so brutal and shocking as Essex police coming in ahead of the bailiffs, kicking everybody in sight of them. Nora Egan was only happened to be in the way of the riot police and was pushed against the wall, and she's now in Basildon General Hospital with a back injury. And we have another mother who is outside her legal home here at the back of Dale Farm. That is Mary McCarthy. She is bleeding from the face, having been pushed against the wall outside her own home. We are compiling this evidence for a very slim hope that an appeal to a judge this afternoon might stop what's happening here. This started as a small matter of a planning inquiry, a planning issue, has now escalated into ethnic cleansing. And I cannot believe that Theresa May is putting £6 million of taxpayers' money into ethnic cleansing travellers who had their own peaceful community here. We were not part of Broken Britain, but they've sent in the riot police to break us up. I cannot believe this is happening. However...
Sorry, just before you move on, I know you want to make a number of points, but before you move on, you use that phrase, ethnic cleansing. That is not what is going on here. This is a dispute about planning permission. It has gone on. It has gone through a variety of court applications, all of which those residents have lost. And this is simply the council now trying to implement what the courts have decided. Well, we've lost that line to Grattan Buxton. Perhaps we'll try to re-establish that in the next few minutes.
Let's head to our correspondent, Jeremy Cook, because he is at the site as well. Just clarify, Jeremy, exactly where you are for viewers, because, of course, we can see a number of riot police behind you there.
Actually inside the illegal side of Dale Farm, and we were here at 7 o'clock this morning when the riot police came swarming through a breach in the fence at the back of the site and made their way past the protesters, as the protesters were throwing stones at them with their riot shields, and just pushed to this point behind us. And this is a crucial point, because what you can see over there is actually a gantry erected over the main entrance, the main road entrance into the site. And that is crucial, because the bailiffs need to use that access in order to get their heavy machinery in order to carry out their legal order to clear much of this site. But they are held up at that position now, and from the really quite fast pace of how things proceeded this morning, things have stalled and going much more slowly now. The reason, you can see for yourself, is because there are so many protesters up in the gantry that you can see, and below them others who are barricaded, locked onto the barricades. And so what the police job now is to one by one remove those individuals. They have to do so safely, clearly. Things have slowed down, but we have seen in the last few minutes that process is continuing, and people are being carried out by the police, removed from the site. That said, you know, there is a lot of tension still here. because over this way, beyond these barricades, is where many of the travellers who've remained on the site are still living, are still looking on, almost in disbelief, I think, because many of them, of course, after all of the legal proceedings of recent weeks, had hoped, if not expected, that there may be a further delay. Clearly, that simply hasn't happened. And from early morning, you see some of the travellers moving around. Now, their children, they have moved off the site. They're all considering what to do next, and really, they're running out of options. And the council have said that whatever the cost, they're going to go on with this eviction. And the way things are proceeding over here now, look, it could take hours, it could take days, but the writing really is on the wall. And if you speak to the travellers here, they know that their time on the illegal plots in this site is over. What they do next is interesting, though, because some of them said to us, look, there are three or four plots within this site which are legal for various technical reasons. And last night what we saw was many of the caravans which had been spread around the site have been concentrated now onto those legal areas. And there is some suggestion that whatever happens with the eviction, that travellers will remain here, that they will remain densely packed onto that site, and who knows what happens when the bailiff, when the whole operation, this multi-million pound operation, goes. What we will not see here, and that's clear already, is a greenfield site. That is not happening, because there are roads and some of the dwellings here will remain. That was what the legal process came up with.
All right, Jeremy, thank you for now. Back to you shortly as well. Jeremy Cook there inside the camp. Just to reiterate, Jeremy there on the illegal section. Of course, as he was explaining, there is, of course, a section of this camp that is he was in the illegal section. There is a section that is legal, of course. One side has planning permission, the other does not. Just to bring you the latest from the ambulance service in Essex, while we stay with these live pictures, the ambulance service confirming to the BBC that one person was taken to hospital from Dale Farm earlier this morning. This happened around about 20 to 9 this morning, the ambulance service says, and it was someone with minor back injuries. That is what is being described. Believed to be a woman, but not confirmed. Believed to be a woman with minor back injuries. That's the latest from the ambulance service.
Let's go back to Mike Sargent, who's there at Dale Farm. And Mike, tell us what the bailiffs, what the police are currently doing.
Well, yes, there's been quite a lot of activity in the last couple of minutes. We've seen a police van pull up to near the front gate of Dale Farm, and we think one of the protesters has come out injured, surrounded by a group of riot police, and we believe it's a protester, and they have been put into that small van there near the front of Dale Farm. So the police appear at the moment to be the ones who are taking anyone who's injured away from the Dale Farm site. And we heard from you a second ago about that one injury earlier. I think that was the one on who was carried out on the other side from where I'm standing of Dale Farm. So it looks like there's at least one more injury, we think, to a protester. But the ambulance services are not themselves able to get into Dale Farm, certainly not from this side, and so it is the police at the moment who are removing anybody who is hurt in this clearance operation.
And Mike, this is an operation that is very, very difficult to actually implement. The protesters, those residents, have had plenty of time to make preparations, haven't they?
Yes, indeed. I mean, they've made extensive preparations even before we thought it was going to begin a month ago. Then we've had all of these legal challenges and delays, and during that time the police, the bailiffs and Basildon Council will have made additional preparations, tried to go through every scenario, every possible eventuality here. But it's still a difficult and a tense situation, because you never know quite how people are going to react until the clearance is underway. You never know quite how far protesters are going to take their resistance, and some of them have been resisting with violence. We saw that initially when the police went in at 7 o'clock this morning as the rocks and other missiles were hurled. Some protesters are protesting peacefully. They will simply stay on their barricades as long as they can, and other protesters are there to to observe, to watch everything that is going on here, watch what the police and bailiffs do, and write down as much of it as possible. So it is a difficult situation here. Even amongst those who've come to support the travellers, they're behaving in different ways. And of course, as are those remaining travellers on the site themselves. And the police, whilst they have wanted today to move in very swiftly and to secure the site as fast as they can, they have to balance that against trying to keep everybody as safe as possible in what is a very unpredictable situation.
Well, Mike, thanks very much. As we see that police vehicle and the efforts that police continue to make there at one of the edges of that site. Just to remind you, we are expecting a news conference, a couple of news conferences in the coming minutes. We'll hear from Basildon Council themselves and also from Essex Police. So we will return. We think those are scheduled around 11:30 and 11:45. So we'll be back to Dale Farm in the coming minutes.
The time now, attentions to some of the